We're here.
I'm Margaret. The cleaning lady? You are Dr. Archer, right? We met once or twice.
Oh, yeah, right. What do you want?
Sarah has the keys for me under the mat. I usually clean on Mondays.
Oh, I don't need you to clean today.
You don't want me to clean today?
Yes. Please leave.
I can't leave.
Why?
My husband dropped me off here, and I don't have a phone to call him, so can I come in and use yours?
Where is he now?
Well, by now, he's at work.
You don't have to call. Come inside. You can wait here.
Thank you.
But I'll still pay you. Come in.
Oh, you don't have to do that.
No, that's all right. She was the one to handle this. Throw it away.
Dr. Archer, I am deeply sorry to hear about Sarah's death. I'll pray for her soul, and may God give you strength.
Thank you.
Is there anything I can do for you?
No, I'm fine.
Have you eaten anything today? Dr. Archer.
What?
Are you hungry? Can I fix you something to eat?
No, don't worry about it. I don't know where the checkbook is. Can I pay you in cash instead?
Don't worry about it. Your mail.
You don't have to.
Don't worry.
Stop! Don't go in there.
The bathroom?
The bedroom.
Okay, I can do it later.
That's not necessary.
It must be cleaned up by
now. Leave it. I don't want anything to be touched in there.
All right. As you wish.
about to board the plane, and I can't reach you on your phone, so I'll call you once I land. There's food in the fridge. Do not call out for food. I love you. Bye. You sure about that one?
Yeah.
Nice.
I am not gonna let you win this one.
We'll see. Don't be a sore loser.
Come on, stop it.
You know, you are playing two against one.
Are you? Are we?
Yeah. I found out this morning. But don't rush anything. I have to go to the doctor in the evening.
Okay.
Checkmate.
When'd you learn to play like that?
Sarah. She taught me. We used to play during my break. I always looked forward to the game.
She was wonderful, wasn't she?
Yes. She was.
Do you know I killed her?
I beg your pardon?
Sarah was stressed. So she decided to visit her parents in San Francisco for a few days to relax. On Tuesday night, her parents came home from dinner. And found her lying in her childhood bedroom. She died of an accidental overdose. When the police came, they asked about her medical history, but they didn't question me.
Why should they question you?
Are you all right? I can't take this anymore.
I'll prescribe you something. I'll get you help.
I'm fine. Go back to sleep.
So I could have done something else. Maybe prescribed something more suitable for her.
Well, was there something more suitable for her?
I don't think so.
Then don't blame yourself, Dr. Archer.
No, you don't understand. It could have been prevented, and she'd be alive right now, and I wouldn't be having this conversation with you.
I understand you aren't comfortable talking about this right now. It's the same with me.
But you got to let go.
I don't want to talk about this right now. It had been a while since. I didn't know what to do.
Please don't do this to yourself.
You don't know what I've done.
I know how it feels to lose someone. I know exactly how you feel, Dr. Archer. I just wanted to let you know there are people in this world just like you, going through similar things like yours, Dr. Archer.
You don't have to call me Dr. Archer. You can call me Jeremy.
All right, Jeremy. Now, Jeremy, I guess I better go finish this ironing before my husband gets here.
No. Leave it. You've done enough for today. I'll do it.
No, it won't take long. Let me finish it before I leave.
No, I insist. Leave it to me.
Well, if you insist... Thank you, Jeremy.
Thank you. Hey, Margaret. Wait. Here, take this. I want you to have this.
No, you don't have to.
No, I insist. This meant a lot to her.
Goodbye, Jeremy.
Goodbye. I'll see you next week.